Hey guys, it's your girl Onana, and I welcome you all to Onana Nation. So if it is your first time on this channel, please go ahead and subscribe as we dive into today's topic. So today we're actually going to be sharing the testimony of this man, Chai Papa Godwo. When God says it's not your time, my people, it's not your time. No matter what the devil does, no matter what situation you find yourself in, when God says it's not your time, it's not your time. God day. So today we're going to share the story of this guy who was coming back from an event in Bamenda, and he met some crossfire between La Republic and Amazonian fighters. You can imagine the poor guy hearing all these loud sounds, boom boom everywhere. He's just confused, so he lay on the floor trying to save himself. He does not even know how God took him from this place to see that the bullets even passed through the car seat where he was sitting. God day. If I could even know how to explain the story, let me stop talking now so you guys can hear what the guy has to say for himself.
So today, I left Bamenda while I was coming to Bamenda because I lost a friend of God, the wind. Around 17 minutes past 6 a.m., we arrived Matas in the morning, and I was about to be controlled by a wind tumor. All of a sudden, I heard shooting. They were shooting so much that all I could do was I had to bend my chair. I bent the chair down flat, and I lay flat in the car. After a while of shooting, they shattered this window, and all the debris of the glass fell on my body inside the car. I stayed calm. After a short while again, the next bullet came through this door. This is the hole here. The bullet entered the door, penetrated, and came out here. While I was lying inside the car, what protected me was the door handle. This door handle caught the bullet, and this is the mark. The bullet entered here, and you can see the attempt to go out here. So after that, I discovered that it was so dangerous to remain in the car. What I now did was I opened that door behind there and jumped out of the car. Since the shooting was continuing, I couldn't run up. I just laid down flat. Then I rolled and came under the car. While I was out under the car for about 7 minutes, while shooting was still going on, another bullet came again, burst the car from under here, and fell directly in front of me. It was very hot. I saw it. I still stayed calm. About 4 minutes later, another one again still burst the car here. Then I discovered that it was no longer safe. I now rolled off and left the car and went under a 70-seater and stayed there for a while. But the most glorious of all, and the reason I thank God most, is because after everything was calm and the shooting lasted for around 30 to 40 minutes, when I came back, I don't know which bullet, but I discovered that a bullet went through my chair. This is a bullet hole. It entered my chair here and passed through and came out behind, That's the hole. But God protected me. The Lord preserved me. That is the story.
Wow. What a story. What a testimony. So I'm just here today imagining what if he wasn't smart enough to go to the floor. Matter of fact, it's not even in smartness. In situations like this, you can see the Holy Spirit guiding you, because it's the Holy Spirit that told this guy go to the floor. If not today, it would be a different story. If not, by now they would have been calling his family, his mother, his father, or maybe his wife and his children. Sorry, your daddy did not make it. Can you imagine? God day, oh God day. So things like this just make me remember the fact that it's not by our might, it's not by our power, it's by the Spirit of the Lord. It's all God. So today we just want to thank God for preserving the life of this young man. This is such an amazing testimony. Where? God day with you, my brother. Your hands are clean indeed. Your hands are clean. That's why God was fighting for you. So thank you guys a lot for watching. I remain your girl Onana. I just thought to share this story with you guys today. Like, the only message I get from here is, if God is with you, nobody can stop you. If God is with you, nobody can destroy you. You're indestructible. No matter what, you're heavenly protected. So have a beautiful weekend, everybody, basking in the grace of the good Lord, basking with the Holy Spirit, and always remember that if God is with you, nobody can ever be against you. The Lord will go before you. The Lord will go behind you. The Lord will go with you. Stay safe, everybody. I love you guys. Go ahead and subscribe if you haven't. Like the video. Leave me comments below what you think about today's topic. And I will see you guys next time. I love you guys. Goodbye.